is up, guys? Max here with another guitar tutorial, and today we are going to take a look at Noticed by Lil Mosey, and boy oh boy did he get noticed. It blew up, still is blowing up, and deservedly so. It's an awesome song, and it is super easy to play on guitar as well, because we've got one riff throughout the entire song, four chords in that, nothing too crazy there, and we don't need a capo, we are in standard tuning. And there is nothing else to say except for shout out to my Instagram down there in the description. If you want to get in touch with me or see what's going on in my life, be sure to hit the follow on that. And without any further ado, let's get into the video. So first of all, let's take a look at the four chords we need in the song. And the first one is an A. We put our first finger onto the second fret on the fourth string, second finger onto the second fret on the third string, third finger on to the second fret on the second string. And now we need our thumb up here. We put it on the guitar neck up there. In order to mute the sixth string, we slightly touch it and we go down once to check what it should sound like. And that's the A. Next up, we've got a C sharp minor. We take our first finger, put it onto the fourth fret across the fifth down to the first string. Then we take our third finger, put it onto the sixth fret on the fourth string, pinky on the sixth fret on the third string, and second finger onto the fifth fret on the second string. Once again, we don't want the sixth string to make a sound, so this time around we take our first finger here and slightly touch the sixth string like that. And then we go down once as well. So we've got the A, the C sharp minor. Next up, we've got another standard chord, an E. We take our first finger, put it onto the first fret on the third string, second finger onto the second fret on the fifth string, and third finger onto the second fret on the fourth string. And this time around, we don't have to mute the sixth string at all. We just want it to be open. And that is our third chord. So we've got the A onto the C sharp minor, by far the hardest switch here. Then we go onto the E major and onto a B. We take our first finger, put it onto the second fret on the fifth string, third finger and pinky. Now we have to cover three strings together. We need to put them onto the fourth string, the third string, and the second string. So there isn't really like a spot on position that I can describe here, because we can't just put the third finger onto the fourth string and have the pinky do the rest. They're like doing this together. So just press down on those three strings and that's the B. And those are our four chords. A, C sharp minor, E, and B. And what do we do rhythm wise? So regarding the rhythm, we have two options here. We can either keep it basic and simple, or we can go a bit more advanced and a bit more creative. First of all, I'm gonna show you the basic stuff. What we do is we just go down once on the A and go down twice on the C sharp minor, down once on the E, and down twice on the B. That is super easy and works perfectly well with the song, because that's basically what the piano is doing. So you don't have to get too crazy here. But as guitarists, we obviously want to have to do a bit more, get a bit more into the song, you know. So what I do is I go down up on the A. Then we go down on the C sharp minor and go down twice. And go down up. So we go like that, and we do the exact same thing with the E and the B. And that is the entire song. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Drop it a thumbs up if you did, helps me out more than you might think, and hit that subscribe button if you are new to the channel, and that notification bell in order not to miss out on any of the upcoming lessons. And as I already said in the intro of the video, Instagram is down there as well, and there is nothing else I have to say except for I hope that I will see you guys next time.